गुड आफ्टरनून लर्नर, आई वेलकम यू ऑल वंस अगेन फॉर अ वेरी गुड सेशन ऑन अ टॉपिक बायर्स बिहेवियर विच इज़ पार्ट ऑफ आवर एम कॉम प्रोग्राम एंड पी जी डी आई बी यू प्रोग्राम. द इट्स पार्ट ऑफ एम सी ओ 006. वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टूडे दैट इज़ बायर बिहेवियर. बिफोर गोइंग इन टू द डेप्थ ऑफ द टॉपिक, वी वुड लाइक टू थ्रो सम लाइट ऑन दिस बिहेवियर एंड its relation with the buyers. Behavior, when we go into the depth of the definition, behavior is a mirror in which everyone sees its own image. Buyer is a person who buy goods for his own use or for industrial purposes. So this is a thing which we are going to discuss today and how it had a relation with marketing management, because MCO 06 is part of our MCOM program. This is for the PGDIBO student also. I am Dr. Subodh Kesharwani. I welcome you all once again on behalf of myself and on behalf of School of Management Studies. We have with us today expert in this area, Dr. Anupriya Pandey. She was previously working with Entrepreneurship Development Institute, Ahmedabad. Now she is with us. So we are going to discuss on this topic related to all this. I request Dr. Anupriya to please initiate the session.
Thank you, Dr. Subodh. Before switching over to the topic, our topic, buyer behavior, I'll prefer to throw some light on the marketing itself, because then we'll further lead to the topic, buyer behavior. So if you're talking of buyer, and before going any further, I would like to tell my students what is the roadmap or how we are going to proceed in this particular teleconferencing. So if you see, first of all, we'll be discussing the overview kind of thing, which is a part of an introduction, and then we'll talk of who is the buyer, what is the definition of buyer, yeah. Whom you consider that he or she is a buyer.
Because what I had talked about this, because the nomenclature, the phenomena of the buyer change from time to time.
Exactly.
A buyer is a person who buys goods for his own use, for industrial purposes also. So sometimes he could be the buyer, he could be the seller.
Exactly.
So its role changes, what you are talking about.
There is no clear-cut definition that Mr. X is a buyer and Mr. Y is a seller, or Ms. X is a buyer, Ms. Y is a seller. I am trying to be, not to be gender biased, while I am using he and she, both the terms. So, as Dr. Subodh Kesharwani mentioned, that when we are talking of buyers, it means all of us, the society, every one of us are buyers.
Yes.
Because if you talk of a society, if you talk of production, what is happening? You being an entrepreneur, if you want to produce something, or even if you are trading, what you are doing, we are procuring things from the society.
Exactly.
So that way you are the buyer from the society.
Yes.
And when you are procuring, there is no free lunch nowadays.
Yes.
So when you are procuring any of the sources, you are paying.
Okay.
So there is exchange. So that way you are a buyer. And in turn, you are going to deliver it to the end user.
Okay.
So now I am the buyer.
Okay.
So that way there is no clear-cut distinction. You are buyer as well as I am buyer. So, and also one more thing I would like to mention. Throughout the session, we'll be using term buyer and consumer, and these two terms we are using interchangeably.
Okay, and customer also.
And customers also. And so this is for the ease of the learners, we are telling that please don't get confused. We'll be using all these terms interchangeably. There won't be any distinction or difference between all these three terms.
So since you are going to initiate now, if you go into the verdict of Mahatma Gandhi, he had given a very good definition as far as customers are concerned. A customer is the most important visitor on our premises. He is not dependent on us, we are dependent on him.
Exactly.
He is not an interruption in our work, he is the purpose to it. He is not an outsider in our business, he is part of it. We are not doing him favor by serving him, he is doing us a favor by giving us an opportunity to do so.
Exactly.
So, you know how powerful the customer is nowadays, because everything is revolving around customer. It's customer centric now.
Yeah.
Even there are a lot of integrated things, lot of technologies are there which are playing a very important role to bridge the gap between the customer and supplier. So we will going to discuss all these things, because since marketing management is here, because marketing management is our course, so we have to throw some light on the marketing management also. So
sure,
we expect from you that you should talk about this area also.
Sure, it will be a pleasure to discuss all these things.
Yeah.
So I'll be, without wasting any time, I'll be switching over to the next slide, which deals with marketing. So if I'm talking of marketing, what is a marketing? You can get enormous definitions in the book. of marketing. But in a layman's language, if you want to understand what marketing is, in my view, there is a central point, right? There are people like us in the market, in the economy. There is one end at the top where the producer is. There is the other end where are the consumers are. So
yes.
There is a gap, all right?
Yes, yes.
And
yes.
Things nowadays with this tough competition, cutthroating competition, cutthroat competition, things don't move, you know, automatically.
Yeah, yeah.
There are some chains, some channels which make them move.
Exactly.
So all the chains, all the channels, all the activities which are involved to facilitate the whole process,
come
the process
picture.
Of exchange, yeah,
yeah, come
that
into.
Comes into marketing.
That's why these people are known as intermediaries. They are bridging the gap, and distribution channel is also there. Once we go into the depth of the marketing and the channels, what you're talking about, it's there now. That redistributors, stockists, CNF and agent, all these are there. So they are basically bridging the gap between the... Now there are different modus operandi also where suppliers directly interacting with the customers,
mm-hmm.
like retail outlets are
yeah.
there. Where say there's a retail outlet known as Big Apple,
mm-hmm.
where the producer is directly interacting with the customers and providing product to them. So this could be one of the way.
Exactly.
And also right now, you know, technology is also, we are going to discuss all these things gradually. Technology is also in picture where there are a lot of integrated software known as customer relationship management and supply chain management is there, which are providing the services in a better manner. And the other part is that there are contemporary way of selling the thing.
Exactly.
Because online selling is there, plastic money had been entered now, credit card payment is there. So we are sitting at our office and doing our transactions from there itself.
With a click we are getting things.
Yeah, so
in fact.
This could be one of the way, what you are saying, that with the mouse click.
Things are at our end.
Yeah.
So, and not only that, Dr. Subodh, even I would like to say, if you think of a business, it starts with marketing.
Exactly.
Because what happens, if we feel that we are the consumers, let's suppose that we are consumers, what
yes.
happens? We have a need.
Yes.
There are some, you know, dissatisfaction, uncomfort,
okay.
discomfort level, which
okay.
we understand that there are certain discomfort within us.
Okay.
But we are not able to identify how we can really get rid of it. For
okay.
example, I'll tell you one example. Few years back, if you talk of, now with the economy is growing, everything is growing, people don't have time. They
yes.
have money, they have big house, but they don't have time. So what happened? People started thinking, what if, and manpower.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is not very easy, especially in metro cities, to get
yeah.
someone who can clean your house, you can
yeah,
do your
yeah.
domestic work kind of thing. So for that purpose, people started feeling that how beautiful it would be if there would be a device, if there would be certain thing which can clean the house within minutes and without any, you know, domestic help sort of.
Yes, yes.
So that way we were just thinking, we were just imagining, alas, I mean, if at all there were some certain things. But it is the marketer who comes into the picture.
Yeah.
He or she identifies what is the need of the customer. Then he conveys it to the business. And then after it is given a particular shape, a physical shape.
Okay.
And with this thought, vacuum cleaner, Eureka
yeah.
Forbes,
yeah,
they launched vacuum cleaner.
Yes.
So see, their action, their work, their role starts from the beginning. Even if you start
yeah.
a business, the role begins from the
yes, yes
this
yes.
thing only. So,
so that's why what you're talking about, that need varies from circumstances to circumstances.
Exactly.
And sometimes there may be saturation of certain thing, then new need had been created. And because when mobile had been created, we were very much happy that now we are very much mobile now. We are
mm-hmm.
able to interact with our counterparts by just dialing their numbers. Later on, SMS comes into picture where if you want to, you're busy somewhere, and now offline you can go and see it. So these type of things are there where things are in black and white. So now SMS is a new thing. So this could be a need created by the vendors from the service providers.
Exactly.
So there's very good examples, and many more examples are coming. Situation to situations are there. So need, what you are telling, that it varies.
It varies. Yes, it varies. And then as a marketer, the speciality
okay.
of the marketer is to identify that need and to see the opportunity that this need can be created into a physical quantity or maybe
okay.
something commodity or maybe something intangible commodity in terms of service
okay.
and then communicating it to the consumer That is why you are spreading information, knowledge to the consumer that look, we are here to serve you with this particular product or this particular service.
Okay,
and
very
now
true.
You can make your work a little easier.
So what do you mean to say that if you are going to give more emphasis to the need, now marketing research comes into picture.
Exactly.
So once we go into the definition of marketing research is needed to find out customer acceptance about the product, its sales and market share analysis. So that's why if they're right now what happened, if any company is there, if they're keen to launch any product, they go for marketing analysis in the beginning stages. Because this market analysis is going to guide them that how their product could be, what are the expectations from the customer ends, and how they can compete with their rivals in the better manner. So that's why statistical tools, data analysis, all these are also there. So we will talk about all these part also, where data is there, information is there, knowledge is there, wisdom is there.
We will gradually move to all those things.
Yes.
And the most beautiful part is this term marketing. It sounds very simple, very easy. But when it comes to implementation, it becomes a little more complicated. Why? Because when you are talking of marketing, you have to deal with persons, human being. And when you have to deal human being, it becomes more complicated. Why? Because you have to understand the psychology of the person. So it is more of understanding psychology, trying to make out and, you know, capitalizing on that psychology. So it is basically, and one more thing, human beings' mind, you can say, is a black box. What is going inside right now, no one can, you know, probe, no one can guess. And two people of the same height, two persons of the same height, maybe of same color, but their attitudes, their likes, their dislikes, and everything, it differs. So you cannot set a common thing for everyone. It's, if I like red color, it, you may not necessarily like red color. So it becomes very complicated for the marketer to understand what buyer needs.
So that is the reason we have got a variation in the products, and the more coverage is there. That's why we have to design the product keeping in mind caste, creed and jurisdictions.
Exactly. And we have to take care of everything.
Okay.
Because if you see the term, even if you are talking of this term buyer behavior, see the evolution. Since 1960 it has gaining importance. And if you can link it, it is during that time when we have focused our marketing approach totally. There is a whole paradigm shift.
Great revamping in this system.
Because earlier what we used to believe, whatever we are producing, it can be sold in the market.
Because
now
monopoly
the situation,
type of situation is there. Now we have got more competition, cutthroat competition is there. This could be one of the reasons what
reasons,
we are talking about.
And now the situation is entirely changed. Because now the in the market, only that product or service is saleable, which is liked by the consumer. So now earlier more concentration, more focus was on product, but now more focus is on buyer,
so it could
or
be
the
more,
consumer.
More customer centric, more
evolving. And that is why all these terms, buyer behavior, and you can, you know, see emerging very coining terms like customer relationship management. If you're talking of, you're talking of customer life cycle value, customer value. These are the terms coining because of this. We have focused more and more on consumers because now the consumer is king. And that is why if you see some of the slides, I'd like to show some of the slide. We'll come to all these things later on. See, can we focus on the slide, please? In the today's context, we have moved our approach from CAT to CARE. CAT is acronym here. C stands for consumer, A for R and T for thing. Consumer, R thing. So earlier we used to think, okay, fine, there are consumers and we have some product and we can sell it to the consumer. But now the whole scenario is changed and we have moved from CAT to CARE. C-A-R-E. C stands for consumers, A for R, R for really and E for everything.
So it's not true what you have told that customer is the king.
Is the king.
And what Mahatma Gandhi had quoted long back. That customer, we have to like give more emphasis to the customers rather than ignoring them.
So before moving any further, if we can you know, throw some light on the basic things often, and I would like to, you know, take you to take the floor and discuss what all the things are there. So can we move a little further and see if the things are there?
So what you're talking about this market, that there are different approaches to marketing. If we go through this figure, starts with, I hope it's not visible to me, but anyway, the customer is at the lower end and there are more customers at the upper end. So what had happened with the help of this marketing strategy, with the help of these tools and techniques like distribution channel and all these approaches, we are floating our product in a better manner. Ultimately, the numbers are going to increase from down level to the upper level.
Yeah.
So this could be one of the way, and in between we have got certain tactics, certain approaches. I hope you can talk that part.
Yeah, in fact, see, this is one of the tactics to make a customer base. Because
okay.
you are targeting, you are penetrating in the market.
Yes,
you are targeting
yes,
one
yes.
customer, then you are trying to attract the customer, you are trying to serve the customer, please the customer, and when the customer is pleased, what is happening, he or she is using the product.
Okay.
And if the condition is there, if the customer likes the product, what happens? Mouth publicity.
Okay.
It is communicated to many other people.
Yes.
And
yes.
then all of them are, they are the potential buyers, but now they are turning to your actual buyers.
Okay.
And those potential buyers are turning to the actual buyers, and that way you are having a large base of consumer.
So eliminating all those China eggs and window dressers.
Everything.
And because now we are reaching towards the real customers, the
real
potential customers. That's why right now, you know, I hope the learners are aware about the multi-level marketing approaches and network marketing, where mouth marketing is there.
Mm-hmm.
And what you talked about, that that rather than following the conventional approaches, we are having a different modus operandi.
Exactly.
And we are selling the product on one-to-one basis.
Mm-hmm.
And then later on it could be reached to the customer. So this could be one of the way, and some incentives, some other approaches are in
there.
Between that. There.
Mm. In fact, you have to start right from the beginning, how to, you know, get the customer and how to convert the potential customer, potential buyer into actual buyer. And
okay.
for the whole thing, you need to understand their psychology.
Okay.
And that is why we need to understand the buyer behavior, the pattern of buying.
So this, I hope now this behavior is a guru mantra, what
exactly.
we are talking about, because
exactly.
if you are not able to know the behavior about the customer, you are not able to float your product in a better manner.
Mm-hmm.
Ultimately, some stumbling blocks will be there. So
exactly.
if you want to avoid all those things, the first and foremost thing could be that how we are going to learn the behavior of the customers. And that could vary from location, jurisdictions. Definitely, we are going to talk this aspect where there are certain, because one product is successful at one place,
mm-hmm.
whereas if the same product is floated at other locations, it
mm-hmm.
could be flopped.
Exactly.
Because lot of factors are taken into consideration. So
mm-hmm.
we are going to talk all these aspects on one-to-one basis.
So I'll move further to our topic, which is related to buyer behavior.
Okay.
If you define buyer behavior basically is a process by which individuals decide whether what,
okay.
when, where, how, and from whom to purchase. See,
okay.
all W's are to be taken care of.
Okay, all W's are
all taken. W's are taken care of.
Okay.
First of all, which individual? Meaning, okay. we are trying to identify the consumer.
Okay.
Who can be, which consumers can be converted into our actual consumer? Because all of us are potential buyers,
okay.
or consumers, you can say. All
okay.
of us are potential. Everyone who is having the money, that is ability to pay and willingness to pay, is
yeah.
a what?
Is
a potential buyer. And we are targeting someone who can be converted into actual buyer. So which individual is the first thing?
Okay.
The second W which we have to take care of is whether. Because sometimes, I discussed in the beginning also, that mind, human resource mind,
okay.
buyer's mind is a kind of black box.
Okay.
So you can never know whether a particular buyer is going to be convinced or not. So at some point of the time you have to make calculations.
Okay.
Whether this, because it is, there is no meaning if you go on wasting your time on a particular consumer who you think that cannot be, you know, converted into a potential or actual buyer. Because there are certain factors. We'll discuss it further. We'll discuss as the session grows through.
So what do you mean to say that sometimes we have to create a market also.
Market also.
Like
exactly.
sometimes we think that there is no market, because there are some good sayings by the different people, that two people had been to different places. One had been to the village where he found that nobody is wearing sleepers and all. So he said that there is no market. This
exactly.
was one of the perceptions.
Exactly.
Other people had been to that place. He said there is a market. There is a big market, because we are now going to tap the people. All the people
and
so
they can wear
yeah,
all
this, so footwear. So this could be one of the way how you're going to interpret the thing. If the glass is half filled, we can say it's half empty or half filled. It's now interpretation.
Interpretation. But Dr. Subodh, one more thing I would like to focus here is that we really need to calculate at some point of time.
Okay.
Because the era is changed now.
Okay.
And the competition is growing like anything. So if we keep on, you know, pursuing, we have to calculate somewhere where we are going to get results, because we have to be more result oriented now.
Yes, yes.
So
yes.
We need not to give all our focus to a particular segment only.
Yes.
We have to really see, we have to really identify whom all can be really targeted, because they have higher probability of being converted into the actual buyers.
Okay.
So these things are to be taken care of, and the most important thing is how it can best suit every purse and pocket.
Okay.
That is most important.
That is more important. That is the reason, because totality comes into picture. Because
yeah,
total
exactly.
Quality management, all these aspects are there which are talking about this part, that rather than confined to particular market, we should explore ourselves and have a global market, what you talked about. So this, because ultimately what will happen, there will be more turnover. In that case, your profit margin will be less, but your turnover will be high. So ultimately, net effect will be that you are getting more profit.
Let's show the learners this thing through a slide. In fact, I think this would be a better slide to explain them.
Okay.
We have to really calculate which buyer is buying what and how many times you are she is buying. And what is the value of that purchase. You know, because that value is going to give him business. See, there is no free lunch, I'll repeat again. So for everything, there is some profitability. If there is no profitability, there is no meaning.
Exactly.
Don't
because
you think so?
The motive of the organization is to generate profit.
Profit by satisfying consumer. And
because
consumer,
this we have learned into the accounting concepts also.
Exactly, exactly.
That profit going concern concept, that organization should be a going concern and business entity should be there, and there must be a profit.
Profit, exactly. And without profit, there is nothing.
Yeah.
So there is something which is known as, you know, customer value.
Okay.
So if you keep on, suppose you have targeted one customer, he or she is buying your product, but he or she is not going to be a, you know, brand loyal kind of a person.
Okay.
So what is happening every time you are targeting a new customer, and he or she is quitting the market, quitting your product, and the someone else is coming. So this is adding cost.
Yes.
Yes, there is a marginal profit also, but this is adding cost. So we have to be careful in, you know, retaining customers also.
And because ultimately what happened, that even this is also talking about that part, that the pain is more in creating a new customer, whereas pain is less if we have an existing customer.
Exactly, exactly.
Because the customers are loyal, they are acquainted with our product now, and what we have to do, we have to retain them by providing better services, more privileges. In the past also, like Reliance and all that had done, if you are going to submit your bill, that phone bills in a timely manner, so what will happen, they are going to provide you some discount, say 5%, 10%. So ultimately you are giving priorities to your loyal customers, because they are loyal towards their towards the product which they are using. So this could be one of the way.
And you see, very beautifully this thing is, you know, illustrated when you go to a local mandi kind of a place.
Okay.
You can see shopkeepers, they engage some person who will tell you, Aye saab, kind of.
Yes,
but
yes.
You go, when you go to some malls, shopping malls, what happens? You enter into the market, and like you, various other customers are entering into the market, and in the meantime there is one announcement: dear customers, we have something which is, you know, having 10% discount, but this is only valid for 2 hours, so please grab the opportunity.
Yeah,
this is all
it's going on. Yes.
And it, how and why? Because of reading the psychology. Because the person who has entered into the market, into the shop or mall, he or she is going to buy something.
Exactly.
So why not to make him buy more and more? And this is the trick. This is the
this
strategy.
Is the even if you see this, the style of working as far as Big Bazaar and all these are concerned, they are providing a card facility.
Exactly.
They have a membership card where if you are repetitive in their shops, so they are going to give you some discounts, say 5% extra discounts.
Extra
apart
discounts?
From the discounts they are giving on that day. So ultimately what they are doing, they are building loyalty.
Loyalty. And also, Dr. Subodh, at times you must also have noticed that those cards, they give this facility that next time when you are coming for shopping, you will get a space to park your car or whatever two-wheeler you are having, and there would be lesser charges, or maybe for 10 times you won't have to pay any fee any you know parking fee kind of thing, and next time if you're coming you'll get some discount. So this is all again they are trying to churn, because nowadays what the problem is, you don't have the place to park yourself, to park your vehicle, to park anything. So what they are doing, they are trying
so
to
so what
understand.
You're talking about again, that need is there, they
need
have
there.
They have basically problem, and all these are there which had taken the shape of the need.
Exactly.
Now they are basically tapping those needs and all and providing services on that basis. So this could be one of the way of
way.
Working.
This is one of the strategy, and that is why we are telling everything is buyer centric, buyer, and we are just doing. I mean, as a marketer, if you are talking, we are just trying to calculate, and we are just trying to read the psychology of the buyer, and
so
this is all we are doing.
So what you are talking about, this picture, I hope
it illustrates even more.
It illustrates this part that how much the loyal customers, and I hope if we have a look on this slide, we can better explore this win loyalty and win profit. So
win loyalty and win profit, exactly.
So this could be one of the way.
With lesser cost, with reduced cost, you are going to earn more and more profit.
Okay.
So this is one way of doing it.
Okay, please. Hello.
This is call from regional center, Rajkot.
ओके प्लीज बताइए.
हेलो.
हाँ यस यस. हाँ
देन वी हैव फ्यू स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ एम कॉम एज वेल एज पीजीडीआईबीओ.
ओके यस.
एंड वी हैव कम्युनिकेटेड अवर लर्नर्स थ्रू एसएमएस फ्रॉम द रीजनल सेंटर.
ओके.
एंड वी हैव टू लर्नर्स वाचिंग द प्रोग्राम.
ओके.
एंड वन ऑफ द लर्नर मिस्टर एस आर देसाई हैज पोस्ट ए क्वेश्चन टू द रिसोर्स पर्सन.
ओके ओके प्लीज कैरी ऑन प्लीज. I request you
what
please.
What are the factors of buyers and what are the consumers' welfare?
Yeah. If we have got your question rightly.
And how it is linked?
Yeah. If you have got your question rightly, you want to know what are the factors that influence buyer behavior. Is it right? Are we getting you right?
Yes, ma'am.
I request
yes.
Mr. Desai to please repeat
yes,
your question. So that we can interpret it and give you the answer of that.
I repeat the question.
Yeah,
that
please.
What are the factors of buyers?
Hmm.
F factor.
Okay. What are the factors of?
Factors even.
Okay, fine. So I'll request the learners to see this slide, please, and we'll focus more and more on all these factors.
Okay.
There are four main factors which influence buyer behavior. One factor is motivation, psychological factors. The other would be social factors. Third is personal factors, and the fourth would be cultural factors. We have just tried to categorize them into four factors. There may be many more. We may be leaving one or two. There may be many more. We have tried to, you know, compile everything into four these categories or classifications, if you say. So if we start from psychological factors. For every work, you need to have some kind of motivation. You know, why we are buying, why we are doing any activity in the economy. What is having when we feel some need or desire, there is a kind of tension in human behavior. I mean, if we need something, if we are thirsty, would be a tension. And unless we consume a glass of water, that tension is not released. So the important thing is, whenever there is a need, the tension is there, and to release that tension, we need to take some activity, and that activity is to consume the glass of water. So that means what? Likewise, if there are certain needs which you want to, and that needs may make you dissatisfied, and to satisfy yourself, you have to consume a particular product or service which has the capacity to satisfy your need. So what is happening? You are buying that. So there are some factors which are psychological, and one is motivational factor. So something, some motive is there, and this motive may be your primary motive. Like there are basic needs. Needs can be basic, or you know, primary needs, primary want, and then there could be secondary wants.
Yes.
Basic being your food, shelter, education, water, everything. And when we are talking of secondary things, everything which is giving you comfort level to make you more efficient.
Okay, even if we take a very good example like sales promotion scheme, where if you buy a toothpaste, you get a toothbrush free.
Toothbrush
so
free.
This could be one of the
yes, exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
So there are many other ways by which the companies are doing. If you go to the retail sectors and all these retail outlets, what they are doing, they are providing better services and some sales promotion type of thing.
Mm-hmm,
so
exactly.
Why you are going to that shop and not purchasing from the shop which is nearby to your house, because obviously the product is standardized and lot of other facilities you are getting. So this could be one of the way.
This is one, yes, exactly. And likewise, you have to, in the very beginning we are discussing that the most important thing is psychology. And
okay.
That is, the psychology drives a customer,
yes,
you know,
because
to enter into the shop or to buy something.
Because what you talked about, that this is the tendency of the mentality of the human beings.
And now, this psychology has impact, or this psychology can be impacted in a way by social, personal and cultural factors.
Okay.
You know, because why I am like this? Why you are Dr. Subodh? Why I am Anupriya? Because there are certain factors which are making us what we are. And
okay.
Those factors are your social factors, your personal factors and your cultural factors.
That could be the reason why, like, there is a good sale of electronic items in the Diwali season. Why?
Exactly.
Because we have made up our mind that Diwali is going to come, we should buy a new thing. So this could be one of the way.
One of the way.
Whereas there are some holy colors to the different communities. They used to do that. So these are the things which can extract them towards the product.
And if you see, don't go anywhere, don't go to the books. If you want to really see how these business people, these marketers, they really are capitalizing on buyer behavior, you just see the advertisements.
Yes, yeah. This
if
could
there
be.
Is advertisement for cosmetic, I'm not going to advertise it. I mean, a common man like me, a common girl like me, or lady like me, is not going to be as a part of that advertisement. Only Aishwarya Rai, Shah Rukh Khan and these people come. Because when the buyer is buying something, he is not buying commodity and service only. He is buying bundles of hopes,
exactly.
Bundles of expectations. So those hopes and expectations, you know, we can convey that if Aishwarya Rai is using Lux and she is becoming fairer and fairer and she is becoming Miss World, you can also be the one if you are using that particular product. So for every ad, you know, if you have to, if they have to advertise some shoes, then they focus more on Pepsi, they focus more on players, sports
okay.
persons. Why? Because then the customers or buyers, they can relate themselves with that particular situation or that particular circumstance.
Yes.
For this example, if you see, yesterday it was Karwa Chauth and I just passed through the market. And it was so beautiful to see that most of the things were in, you know, red color.
Okay.
See, situation, culture.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
So,
because
this could be the reason which had extracted the customers towards the product.
Anyways, we are coming to all these topics one
yes,
by
yes,
one.
Yes, yes.
We'll come to all these topics one by one.
But I request learners to have more questions from their end, because this is a very good session. We are discussing all these aspects on one-to-one basis. So if there could be any query from their end, this is going to make the concept more
because conceptual
clear.
Thing you can go through any book, textbook, and you can get it. So if you have some doubts or some queries,
though we are going to cover all those topics on one-to-one basis, but still if there could be any query, we can move to that part, and again we will come where we are.
Exactly.
So I hope Mr. Desai had got the answer, and there are some more things which we are going to talk about this. So what you are talking about, this motivation, so motivation could be of different kind. It could be in cash, it could be in kind,
anything. See, again I would like to quote some example. When you go to Big Bazaar,
yes.
They have certain offers.
Okay.
At times they give you that if you buy something worth more than 1500, you'll get a bed sheet which is worth ₹500.
Yeah.
So you can say it is in cash also, it is in kind also. Or sometimes they give you a coupon. Next time when you are coming to, you know, buy anything, when next time when you are coming for shopping, you can produce this coupon and you will get commodities or products worth ₹250 free
okay.
next time. So it can be in cash, it can be in kind.
Okay. So this could be there, and I hope we should continue now.
We will continue, exactly. And this, all these psychological factors, like we were discussing motivation. For motivation, there are certain experts who have given various theories, but the most important theory, there are two most important theories in psychology which are linked to marketing, and those two theories are one, Abraham Maslow's need hierarchy theory, due respect to him, and the other is Sigmund Freud's theory. So when we are talking of this need hierarchy theory, very clearly he has mentioned that there are five stages.
Okay.
You know?
I request to please show the slide.
Yeah. See, there are five stages. One is your physiological need. First of all, this is the basic need.
Okay.
Other, the upper needs, they won't occur unless you are fulfilling your first need.
Okay.
Then when you are satisfied with the first need, then you can go to the other ladder. The other step is your safety need.
Okay.
Once you are, your stomach is full, then you know, you need to have some security. Now you need that security that today I have got this food. Can I get this every day, both times, both the meals? So for that you need to have a job.
Okay.
Right? So this security. Then, right, this time I have got a shelter to protect myself. Can I hire a house or can I buy a house which can give me security in long term? So then it comes the second need. The moment your second need, that is safety needs, is fulfilled, you are satisfied, then it comes your social needs. Now I have got a house, I have got a job, now I can, you know, satisfy my basic needs and all the security needs. Now I'll come to the third need, which is social need.
Okay,
fine, I've got a job, but now I really wish that two subordinates are there and they are wishing me when I'm entering into the office.
Okay.
That is what?
Some social
society.
Yeah.
You know, that when you're coming out of your house, there are certain people who know you by your name. Hello, Dr. Subodh, how are you?
Yeah.
Sort of. And then you feel good that there are certain people who are knowing me. So that kind of need is also important, which is known as social need. And then comes esteem needs, you know, very different, very peculiar kind of.
Should we have very good examples related to this?
Esteem
Like, say I have owned a Maruti 800, now I am switching with that Honda City car.
Because many of your colleagues must be having it.
So
why not to?
Because already I am fulfilling my basic amenities, but just to fulfill this esteem need, I have gone through this.
And not only that, with the increasing competition, you see, earlier women, they used to compete with each other by showing, see, I have these many sets of jewelries and you have these many. Now the situation has changed.
Yes.
Now they say, I have this branded jewelry.
Okay.
Do you have this?
Okay.
So see, with time, and this is all again.
That is the reason that branding, like brands and other things are there, which are creating their own market.
There are conventional brands
by this small
If you talk of a decade back, not many people were knowing what is Didymus, isn't Now if you're talking of a jewelry, if you're talking of a diamond, you know, first thing comes to your mind is any brand like this.
I'm not supporting
any brand, but any brand like this. So
even in shoes also, the right now the people are preferring Reebok and Adidas compared to the small players, because they are thinking that these are
making it different from others.
Even in wristwatches also, there are a lot of brands which are foreign brands, which are Omax and other players are there, which are providing
A kind of satisfaction. This is again psychology. See, if you are wearing a common shoe, that is giving you the same comfort. If you are wearing a woodland shoe, that is also going to give you the same comfort, but maybe some more added advantages. But again, the thing is, with woodland, you get that kind of satisfaction that I am wearing a branded shoe. With a Peter England shirt, you are satisfied that I am wearing a branded shirt. So that is the kind of thing. And then the last motivational factor, the last need which Maslow has defined is self-actualization need. When you are satisfied with everything, you have got money, you have got social respect, your esteem is high, then comes your self-actualization.
Okay,
I have born, I have got everything, but can I earn some fame? Can I earn some name? So that gives this thing self-actualization.
Actualization need is concerned, it is far away from all these four needs.
Yeah, far away from all those.
More satisfaction is there, more intangible type of satisfaction is there.
But again, the most complicated thing is, you cannot say that, okay, this need is satisfied, don't look for this, come to the other need. No, because it is not that if you satisfy one need at a particular point of time, it is not going to occur again. It will occur again.
Okay.
So you have to see all the needs of a consumer simultaneously.
Okay.
And again, you have a large base of consumer.
So what do you mean to say, we are not going to ignore any of it?
Any of
it. Gradually it will go.
Any of it. The only thing is, you can segment your market accordingly. If you are going to, if your target is low end customer, then you will have a different set of commodities, different set of everything strategies. And if your target market is high end customers, high end buyers, your marketing strategy would be different. That's the only difference.
That is the reason in shoes also, lot of players are going on. Reebok, Adidas, no doubt have their good market.
Mm-hmm.
But apart from it, simultaneously, small players are also working well.
Working well, really. Because then you cannot ignore all this. See, Reliance Fresh is there. But are those, you know, mandi wala, sabji walas, are they vanishing? No, they are still there.
Yes, yes.
Because, fine, you wanted, you didn't have time, you have everything but you didn't have time. So you wanted a place where you can go once and you can buy everything. You wanted to buy fresh vegetables, you went to the Reliance Fresh store.
No,
so,
even,
but there are,
yes,
yeah.
Even the Parchunwala is also not going to be
vanish,
eradicated.
Yeah.
Reason is that what you're talking about, this need. Hmm. Sometimes what happens, instant we need a product.
Yeah.
So at that time,
and in small quantity.
In small quantity.
Yeah.
So that in that case, we directly go to these people and buy it. As retailing, so retail sectors and all these retail outlets
exactly.
have got their different way.
Exactly.
So it varies from situation to situation.
Situation to situation. And see, this is, you know, commerce. And this okay. is something which is practical. So there is no hard and fast rule.
Okay.
2 plus 2 is not always 4. For us,
okay.
business persons or commerce, you can say 2 plus 2 may be 4, maybe 5, maybe more than 5, maybe less than 5. How? If your standard and your actual is same, 2 plus 2 is 4.
Okay.
If your actual is, you know, or your standard you set is lesser or lower than your actual, meaning 2 plus 2 is more than 4. It may be 5, it may be 6, it may be anything.
Yes,
depending
yes.
upon your profitability.
Yes.
And it is less, it is showing our a kind of, you know, failure. That this is what we tried, this was the target, this was the standard, and we are producing, in fact, lesser than that. So it may be less than 4. So there's nothing hard and fast. Everything is, you know, contingent here. It depends on situation and it varies from person to person, from places to places, and from situation to situation. See, so that is why in the beginning I mentioned that marketing word sounds very easy, but implementation is really very complicated.
Exactly.
I won't say it is difficult because nothing is difficult. We have to do everything. But yes, it is very complicated and it needs attention. And marketer really plays a very, very important role. So, and because he is or she is, you know, linked with the end users.
Okay. Because, you know, there was a very good quotation which had been quoted by Dhirubhai Ambani long back that when mobile was not everybody cup of tea, at that time he had quoted that I am going to bring mobile as a basic amenities,
yeah.
in the cadre of the basic amenities. How he had quoted that roti, kapda, makan and mobile. So why he was comparing roti with mobile? Because he thinks that in a coming future, mobile is going to not replace the roti, but it will be at part
as
of the
as important as roti is.
Yes.
Yeah.
So now you see everybody have got a mobile.
Yeah.
So this need had been created by him only, and in today's scenario also there are a lot of like initially we were using the black and white sets. Now we are using a colored set with multimedia enabled facilities and other facilities are there.
Exactly.
With
exactly.
internet facility and all because the need had been created.
Mm-hmm.
So. They are different. They are different classes. For them, we are creating this market.
And it is all the game of, you know, understanding and classifying and trying
yes,
to cover
yes,
more
yes.
and more.
And that is the reason the old product become redundant and new product
comes in. Yeah, and not only, you know, even if you're talking of the old product, they come
Dr.
Pandey, after some time.
Huh? I hope we have talked a lot about this marketing behavior, consumer, customer, buyers, and all. But you know, time is short and journey is very long. And really, that was a thought-provoking lecture from your end. And I hope a student had learned a lot. Learners have a very good view about this all this buying behavior. I hope, though we have not able to complete all our slides, but in the coming time, if we get an opportunity, we try to cover all these remaining parts. Thank you. Thank you,
Dr. Anupriya. Thank you.